Contestant number 10, Kim Huber. Contestant number 7, Becky Lee. Contestant number 6, Kathleen Carroll. Contestant number 22, Jill Gardner. And our final contestant in the top 10, contestant number 12, Debbie Miller. I'd like to take a moment to talk about the special folks in Elgin, the Miss Illinois Pageant, a reality here in Elgin. We'd first like to thank the City of Elgin for their gracious hospitality. I'd also like to thank the following gentlemen who were working with Wendy Whitson and Larry McMorris to put on such a great week. Please stand when I call you. Larry Rice, the City Manager of Elgin. George Vanderboy, our Mayor here in Elgin. Along with Mike Turner and Clay Pearson. I'd like to know if you have been here the last 2 nights, the City of Elgin has donated $10,000 to the scholarship money for tonight's contestants. Now, before we start our competition tonight, I'd like you to meet a young lady who knows a whole lot about winning. She was a non-finalist talent winner and winner of the Fruit of the Loom Quality of Life Award, a $10,000 award that she donated to the Chicago House, which is a home for AIDS patients. Please welcome Cheryl McGurk. Before we start with Cheryl, she will perform the talent that she did in last year's pageant, Omio Babino Carlo from Gianni Tucci. Cheryl?
Oh,
We'd also like to thank a few of our national sponsors. We'd like to thank the Clairol Corporation, the Chevrolet Motor Division, which, by the way, gives us the prize from this America pageant, a brand new Corvette. Thank goodness it's not the GR1. That's the one that goes 190 miles an hour. Crafted with pride in the USA, Council Incorporated, the Gillette Company, Personal Home Care Division, and the Home Furnishings Council. We'd also like to thank the City National Bank of Chicago for their sponsorship of this year's Quality of Life Award, and the winner will be announced at tonight's final. I guess before we move on to the program, let's find out what this is all about. Somebody must know how I like socks, huh? Look at that. I guess it goes along with the young man. Hi, Jim, I didn't want you to feel left out. Your love of socks has been well documented, so I designed this pair especially for you, the perfect pageant sock. Enjoy this. Robin Elliott. Robin will buy the gown for our ladies. Robin, thank you so much. I'm going to take them home. I've never had sequins on before. And I've never dressed in front of people before. Fred Clayton was supposed to be ready to kill time. As my good buddy Keith Jackson would say, Lord, Millie, I tell you, you got a buckler here tonight. Thank you, Rob. Okay. Let's bring back Cheryl now. We're going to talk to her for just a couple of minutes and chat and see how her year has been. How do you like my song? It's an old rap song back in the day. You like me now. I guess I can tell my wife, I'm in sequins, baby. Match that song, too. It's a big rock. It's a painful thing. How have you been?
Great.
Yesterday we talked about you being a stockbroker in San Francisco. And I just thought, you were at the back of the hotel today getting ready for the pageant. Yes, but I went and played your favorite game.
Oh, you went golfing.
I went golfing. I went over to Spartan Meadows, and I shot an 84, and I played with this wonderful couple I had in the book. By the way, she played golf. You didn't know that.
I said.
How do you play? What's your name?
I'm bad.
It's under 100, right?
Oh, yeah.
That's good. Tell us, the last night at Central Illinois, 1991, you have any heart complications?
No, actually, I've been thinking, I rushed today this afternoon, I sang at the Cubs game, and I've been running around like crazy today, and the last person I've been thinking about was myself, so I'm coming here. Ooh, okay. Trying to get going here.
Yeah, it's been a great year.
Oh, it's been wonderful. Being in Illinois, I've worked in so many opportunities, and I've learned so much that I'm very excited. We call the top 10, and to know that one of those girls is going to have the opportunity that I had is really exciting.
By the way, we have something for you here. Fred dug this up, and we had it framed, and it was last year. It was the runner-up MC list that I had to read of all the girls' names. We got it for you. Yeah, that's
Fred,
what it's
producer, for.
Put the light on the Fred down there. Okay. Stand up, Fred. This is the man that puts it all together. That's crazy, right? We'd also like to bring out a young lady who you're very familiar with too, and who was a Miss Illinois and became Miss America, Marjorie Vincent. Marjorie? number 13, Jennifer Von D. Contestant number 10, Kim Hubert, Miss Northwest Illinois. Contestant number 10, Kim Hubert, Miss Northwest Illinois. Contestant number 7, Becky Lee, Miss Blackhawk Valley. First two are swimsuit and evening gown, each weighing equally 15%. The personal interview with the judges, which you do not see, is worth 30%, and talent counts for 40%. We're pleased, as always, to have a very experienced panel of judges who take the task here tonight of judging all of our contestants and picking Miss Illinois for 1992. Let me take a moment to introduce them to you now. Judge number one is Sharon K. Arnie, presently employed as director, president of Cranford College in Kansas. She received her bachelor's degree in business administration from Southwestern State College in Oklahoma. Now, for the past 10 years, Sharon has developed training programs and seminars for participants in the Miss Kansas Pageant system. She organized and directed the Miss Hutchinson Scholarship Pageant for 12 years and now serves as the grooming and image consultant for Miss Kansas. She's the first woman inducted into the Hutchinson Organization of Rotary International and was nominated by the Hutchinson Downtown Development Council for Businesswoman of the Year. Sharon makes her home in Hutchinson, Kansas. Please welcome Sharon K. Arnold. The second judge is Adair Brown of Denver, Colorado, currently serving as executive director of the Miss Colorado Scholarship Pageant. He previously was associated with the Miss Kansas Scholarship Pageant as executive director. Adair has considerable experience in judging the Miss America preliminaries at the local level, and he has judged over 20 state competitions. On four occasions during the past 5 years, Miss Colorado has finished as one of the top 10 finalists at Miss America. For the first, second, and third runner-up during those 5 years, Adair has helped establish and distinguish the Colorado program as one of the best in the country. Adair is a graduate of Northwestern State College in Alva, Oklahoma, and he's the vice president of Shaw Construction Company in Denver. He and his wife, Susan, have three children, Julie, Randy, and Ryan. Please welcome Adair Brown. Barry Hall has been involved with the Texas Pageant program for the past 31 years, and he has worked in nearly all areas of the pageant. Mr. Hall is presently the chairman of the board and chief executive officer of the Miss Texas Scholarship Pageant. He's judged hundreds of local and state pageants throughout the nation, bearing his country and joy as the claims manager for Homeowners Warranty Corporation with offices in Irving, Texas. He's a graduate of Texas Christian University. Barry and his wife Linda reside in Fort Worth. Please welcome Barry Hall. Dale Sanders has been associated with the Miss South Carolina pageant since 1964. She's been involved in all areas of the pageant system as a producer, a writer, a judge, and a chaperone. Presently, she is the editor of the newsletter there, as well as the program book series. In addition, she has served on virtually every committee and organization since 1976. It's been her responsibility to prepare Miss South Carolina for the Miss America pageant. In 1991, she was inducted into the Miss South Carolina Pageant Hall of Fame. She's an active volunteer in community, civic, and cultural affairs. She served on numerous boards in the Greenville and Liberty area, and has recently been named to the committee to select South Carolina's Woman of Achievement. She's married to Joseph P. Saunders III, who is the president and executive director of the Miss South Carolina Pageant, and they are the proud parents of one son, Joseph P. Saunders IV. They reside in Liberty, South Carolina. Please welcome Dale Sanders. Our sixth judge, Steve Hinger, brings 11 years of experience to the Miss America program. He's judged many local and state pageants, from Maine to North Carolina to Arizona to Louisiana. He served as executive producer for the Miss Bowling Green University pageant. He's been the executive director and the executive producer for the Miss Cincinnati pageant, and he's also been a featured vocalist for both the Miss Ohio and Miss Iowa pageant. Currently an actor residing in Chicago, and Mr. Hinger has much stage experience in theater and vocal performance. Please welcome Steve Hinger. This time we'd also like to introduce our editor for the TV and certified public accounting firm of McGladrey and Pullen. Please welcome Mark Schreiner and Jim Mann. Gentlemen. Now it's time for our talent competition. Each contestant has a chance to demonstrate her chosen area of performance. The judges will be looking for technical competence, that is, her pitch, her tone, and her technique. They'll also be looking to see that her performance challenges her ability. Does she challenge the audience to watch her, and did she successfully use her talent to entertain? Here now, the first contestant for tonight's talent competition. Nothing transcends time like the classics and good music. Tonight, performing Rodgers and Hart's semi-classical with a song in my heart is Deborah Helgerson, contestant number 16, Miss Collinsville. Thank you. trained classically for 10 years are an instant and lost her heart to the old standard while studying musical theater at Syracuse University. Tonight she will perform an original arrangement of Rodgers and Hart's traditional favorite, My Funny Valentine, the Broadway hit Vain in Honor. Here now is contestant number two, Mrs. Lincoln Frail, Karen Marie Navy.
Thank you.
Natural White, Fruit of the Loom Incorporated, Kenneth, Disney, Slim Fast Foods, and Vail Fine Girls. Thanks to all of them for their help in putting on the pageant tonight, East Illinois 1993. Music of the Night from Andrew Lloyd Webber's Phantom of the Opera takes place in the cavern far below the theater house. A phantom casts a spell over the young Christine by singing this enchanting melody. Here to perform this piece is contestant number 23, Miss Iroquois County, Michelle Lynn Henry.
Thank you.
also like to thank the Port Edward Restaurant, Medieval Times, for their outstanding display at the opening ceremony, and the Winston McMurray Advertising Agency. In the Broadway musical Gypsy, we are captivated by perhaps the most famous overture in musical theater history. It performed a dance twirl, a routine of rousing music, is contestant number 10, Kim Buford, Miss Northwest Illinois.
Thank you.
also like to thank a few of the folks who donated the raffle of this year's fundraiser, including American Airlines. They donated two rounds of air tickets, myself first, a full-length fur coat, and complete 1 week stay at the Heartland Spa. We thank those folks for their time. We'd also like you to stay in your seats after the show for the awards ceremony, which will be on stage, and then that's followed by a free reception in the Hammond's basement for the time that I like to call milky cookie time, but it'll be cookies and punch, along with coffee before you are done. Cookies and punch for children, my dear. Our next contestant has been studying classical piano for 18 years. She will now perform passionate and dynamic Hungarian Rhapsody number 2 in C sharp minor by Franz Liszt. Please welcome contestant number 6, Kathleen Farrell, Miss Kankakee County.
Providing phones for our pageant fans.
Well, many of us at one point in our lives have felt that we were facing storms of life alone. In the musical Carousel, they probably on the stage, but it is solved through a song. A song that reminds us that we are never truly alone. Here to perform You Will Never Walk Alone, the Carousel, with contestant number 22, Miss Land of Lincoln, Jill Garland. is coming. Free, rock and stop and easy to go for. I got to stop. I'm going to go take care of these gentlemen. We're on a 15-minute mission, and we'll be home.
Equipment and the same kind of background that they would get in another hospital or in private practice.
Thank you.
Kim, as Miss Illinois, what would you do to encourage adults to overcome their reluctance to address their illiteracy?
Actually, as Miss Illinois, I would do much of the same thing as what I'm doing now. I'm volunteering my time to teach an adult how to read. I would travel throughout the state and encourage others who can read or teach those who want to learn to read. I would also spend time lobbying the General Assembly in Springfield to see that funding for these programs would continue during tough fiscal times. I would also do public service announcements so that those who do not know how to read will find out the information that they need to so they can have that opportunity.
voluntary to die in America, and believe your generation will reverse that trend.
In all actuality, volunteerism is on the increase in America and has increased in Illinois as well. I believe that our generation is a prime example of people who are giving up themselves between the ages of 25 and 44, which are the majority of people who are volunteers. So I believe that volunteerism is on the increase, and we're seeing positive benefits in all of our communities all across the country. Debbie, could our military be used to fight the war on drugs? Definitely. In fact, my platform is drug addicted babies, and if we can do anything to help the children of our future, we need to do that. We need to implement programs, whether it's the military, whether it's home programs on state or local level, whatever it may be, we need to invest in our children, the children of our future, so they are not a lost generation.
Thank you.
Pageant efforts are absolutely paramount, and they're our local pageant directors. We'd like them to stand as well as the state board of directors and the entire state staff. Please stand, put your hands together. Also, we'd like to have the fundraising committee. They've worked so hard to make it possible for us to give forth $27,000 in educational scholarship money. Chairman is Elizabeth Bertucci, and the co-chair is Kathleen Reynolds. Ladies and please stand. And also, Fran, put the light on Fran, stand up. He is our executive director of the Illinois Scholarship Pageant, and she has done an absolutely marvelous job in spearheading the Miss Illinois Pageant, getting this thing going and keeping everything going in the right direction. Fran? Well, we're getting close, folks. Getting close to the end where we picked Miss Illinois for 1992. You know, there's been a galaxy full of stars in Hollywood, Katharine Hepburn, Cary Grant, Jimmy Stewart, Betty Davis, and Greta Garbo, to name a few. But when we talk movie musicals, one name often rises to the top. That man's name is Fred Astaire, and that man is Dan. Here we see him with his most famous partner, Ginger Rogers, who is seen from The Gay Divorcee. Mark Robbins, Karen Pauley, and our vocalist, Iris Lieberman, and Mark Kaplan. And now, once again, our contestants for Miss Illinois 1992. 1992.
Man on the top of the mountain didn't fall off there.
I learned through my volunteer work with AIDS and Chicago Health that it's truly better to give than to receive. And it wasn't until Miss America Pageant last year that I realized that he is only a resource. Most of all, I learned that I had a lot more to learn.
Before we crown Miss Illinois, we have the Quality of Life Award. And for that, we need to bring up Larry Steiner, Vice President of the Mid-City National Bank of Chicago. Larry, it is sponsored by Mid-City National Bank of Chicago. This award encourages and rewards the men and young women in the Miss Illinois Pageant program who donate their time and talents to worthwhile community projects. Larry? The instrument of communication. Mark?
The Mid-City National Bank of Chicago is proud to sponsor the $1,000 scholarship for the Quality of Life Community Service Award. Mid-City Bank is an active participant in numerous valuable community organizations and participates in a variety of ways. Mid-City Bank offers assistance not only financially, but also through the volunteer efforts of its staff and officers to bring together a broad range of skills to effect a change for the better. Mid-City, like our contestants, is committed to serve the community and help boost the quality of life for everyone. The essays that were submitted for the Quality of Life Community Service Award detail the commitment the contestants have had to help others by donating their time and talent to many worthwhile community projects. The variety of these projects that contestants are involved in demonstrates the tremendous need for dedicated volunteers by organizations throughout our state. I think we should all follow their lead in doing our part to help the community, and we can take pride in the efforts put forth by the contestants, and that the true winners of this competition are the recipients of the people who benefit from these projects. The entries were evaluated on participants' involvement and implementation of the project, their motivation, time commitment, and benefit to the community. On behalf of the Mid-City National Bank, I'm honored to present the scholarship for the Quality of Life Community Service Award to Ms. Blackhawk Bailey. Thank you.
The envelope, please. Thank you. We will start with our fourth runner-up. Is contestant number 10, Kim Huber, Miss Northwest Illinois. Number 22, Jill Gardner, Miss Land of Lincoln. Our second runner-up is contestant number 23, Michelle Henry, Miss Carol. First runner-up is, and in the case that Miss Illinois 1992 wins the Miss America Pageant, the National Filler Beauties of Miss Illinois, the first runner-up will step into her shoes. Our first runner-up is contestant number 12, Debbie Hill. Now the moment you've all been waiting for, the new Miss Illinois. 1992 is contestant number 6, Ted. We wish her the best of luck, and we know she's going to win.